praise you, Father God, as we enter, Father God, into the end of this week, Father God. For this Friday, Father God, we thank you, Father God. We praise your holy name, Father God. We thank you for blessings. We thank you for waking us up this morning. We thank you for starting on our way. We thank you for protecting us, for being a provider, for protecting our children, our grandchildren, or our husbands, or our wives, family members. Father God, we pray, Father God, because right now we have so many problems, Father God, in our community, so many problems in our country, so many sick people, so many children that are sick, Father God. Oh, Father God, you said we're living in the last days. These are the tribulations, the perilous times, Father God. And Father God, the only one that can help us out and protect us is you, Lord. Oh, Father God, touch the heart of those who listen to these prayers. Father God, touch them right now, Father God. We pray right now, Father God, for the school system that our children are in, from the elementary all the way to the universities, Father God. Protect them from danger seen and unseen. Father God, ban up every instrument of the enemy, whether it's male, female, flesh and blood, or any type of instrument, whether invisible or physical, guns, weapons, bind it up, Lord. Father God, loose your angels. Loose your angels right now. Loose your heavenly army to surround the schools and enter into the schools, Father God. And protect, Father God. Protect the children. Protect the administrators. Protect the workers. Protect them in the cafeteria. Protect them everywhere in the gym. Protect them, Father God. In the name of Jesus, Father God, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name. Now we pray for the sick, Father God. We keep the sick in memory, Father God. For those who love you, for those who do not know you, for those who are sick in the bed, from the children's hospital to the hospice, Father God. Oh, Father God, we ask that a special anointing fall upon your doctors, your nurses, and your servants right now. We pray that your anointing will pour upon them, Father God, and that you will guide their hands even through the surgery, that you will guide even the police, the ambulance technicians, as they arrive on the scene, Father God, that you will guide and protect them right now, Father God, that you will heal the bodies of the children, Father God, of those adults and even those elderly. You will heal them right now. Father God, heal every form and shape of disease, cancer, every form of chronic disease, from the lungs, from the crown, from the top of the head, crown, all the way to the bottom of the feet. Every organ, we command every organ in the body, every blood vessel in the body to line up underneath your order of creation, the way you created it, and for them to function properly according to your order of creation, dear Lord, that you have created the human body to function in Jesus' mighty name. We pray for those who are in the prison system today, Lord. Oh, Father God, as we continue to pray for the children in the juvenile system, for the adults, for the innocent, and for those who don't know you, that you are God. Father God, have mercy upon your children, or even those who be lied upon, even those that made mistakes, Father God. Have mercy upon them, Father God, in Jesus' mighty name. As they enter into the court, Father God, whatever wicked judge sitting there, Father God, take over every district attorney, every lying wicked testimony and falsehood that they lie against a child of God and a false witness. We bind them right now, Father God. We command them to drop right now and repent on their knees. Every lying document, every falsification, every false recorded testimony, in Jesus' mighty name. Investigators who lie, district attorneys who lie, police officers who lie, enemies of men and women who lie, wicked spirits that possess and make them lie, wicked judges that lie, that pledge alliance to the one world order to do depopulation and incarcerate the innocent. In Jesus' mighty name, we come against every satanic leadership in the spiritual leaders, every satanic spiritual leader and politician leader. We command, Father God, that the Spirit of God will loose upon them and rebuke them. Rebuke them from the north, the south, the east, and the west. Rebuke the libertarian evil spirit of the one world order that the foundation is in this country. We rebuke them, Father God. Only you can rebuke them, Father. Rebuke them. Rebuke them sharply. Rebuke them coming out. Rebuke them coming in. Rebuke them that they're destroying the laws of the land. The laws of the land. The laws of the land. And in hell care, Father God, every satanic power that is manufacturing any satanic medication to do depopulation, every plague, we come against every plague in this system. every sickness that they try to induce in our community, whether in the airways and the waterways and the earth and the food that we eat, Father God. We come against that. We ban up every satanic seed of the GMO, every satanic seed that is planted, Father God, and destroy your order of creation, Father God. Your order, oh, you created the animals to be fed. The order of creation, oh, you commanded every seed to grow. Father God, in the name of Jesus, put an end to the wickedness of the wicked. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Father God, bless us all today. Bless us. Bless us with your gift of your Holy Spirit. Bless us with your holy anointing. Bless us, Lord. Teach us how to fight in the spiritual realm. Destroy principalities and powers, rulers of darkness coming against us right now. Loose your heavenly host, Father God. Loose your mighty army to fight, Father God. Loose the power of the Holy Spirit. Loose the power of the healing blood of Jesus. Heal, O Lord. Send healing, Lord. Send healing to our bodies. Send healing to our mind, our spirit, and our soul. Send healing, Father God. Send command, Father God. Send command right now in the name of Jesus Christ, Yeshua, we pray. And Father God, we thank you. We thank you that you have rebuked the reviler, that you have rebuked every satanic power, that you have rebuked and cast out principalities and power, that you have let us see a brand new day. Oh, Father, thank you. Thank you in Jesus' mighty name. We praise our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Oh, we thank you, Father. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you, Jesus. We thank you for all that you have done. From the beginning, you are the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. We glorify you, magnify you, Jesus. You are the Word, according to the book of John, chapter 10. You are the Word, and the Word became flesh. Emmanuel, King of King, Lord of Lord, the Rose of Sharon, oh, the God of Shiloh. Oh, Father God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, we glorify you, we magnify you, oh, we lift you up, and we give you all praise. We give you all praise. He is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is a miracle working God. There is nothing impossible for the Lord. If you need a blessing in your job, in your business, an increase, Lord, we pray today that you will receive increase. Promotion does not come from the north, the south, or the east, or the west, but promotion coming from the Lord. He will promote you. He will promote your business. He will promote you. He will promote you in your job. He will lift you up. He will bless you financially. Every spirit of fear, every spirit of darkness, he will rebuke it. Every spirit of poverty, every spirit of shame, every spirit of sickness and disease in the body, we reject it right now in Jesus' mighty name. I say, he's a miracle working God. He is a miracle working God. He is the Alpha and Omega. He is a miracle working God. He is a God of miracles. God can do anything, anytime, anywhere. God can do anything. He is Lord. He is a healer. He is a healer. He heals not only the body, the soul, the spirit, the mind. He heals. Already heals, he heals. He is a healer. Oh, don't give up and don't give in. I said the Lord is your healer. The Lord is your protector. The Lord is your provider. He guides you, protects you, protects your children, he protects your husband, your wife. He protects your family. He protects you while you sleep. He protects you from danger, seen and unseen. He is a protector. He is a guide. He is a keeper. He is a cardinal. He's the one that knows what you're going to say before you say it. He can read your mind. He's the only one can read your mind. I said, the psychic don't know it. The psychic, you familiar spirit. Oh, Father God, touch the people of God right now. Touch your people right now. Give them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding for understand that the time is drawing near. The time is so near for the Antichrist to be manifested. Oh, thank you, Lord. Open up blind eyes. Let them see. Let the blind man see, Lord. Let the deaf ear hear. Let the ear you, Father God, in Jesus' name. tonight, your name I pray. We give you thanks and glory. Oh, Father God, we give you glory and the honor. Dear God, he will take your impossibilities and turn it to possibilities. He is the only one. There's nothing impossible for God. Keep having faith. Keep strengthening yourself with faith. Keep remembering. Sometimes you have to bring God and remember of all his promises and the things that he said he will do in his word. And oh, it's so beautiful. Come and see how sweet God is. It's only a test. It's only a test like Job. It's only a test. And you're going to pass 100%. Thank you, Father, in the name of Jesus. And today we're going to be teaching. The title for today is Abominations. Thank you, Lord. Bless your word. Abominations. We live in a time and a period when holy men of God and holy women of God of old, from the disciples and the prophets of old, wanted to be alive in this last generation. This is the last generation. This is the generation of the fig tree. The generation of the fig tree is Israel. How do you plant a fig tree? Once the fig tree is planted, you just break it off and you shoot and you put it in the ground. It's not planted with a seed. So Israel is the only country that was established and then went back to the same location, geographical location, and the same capital, which is Jerusalem. It is biblical. It is the hand of God. The United States of America, in Ezekiel chapter 8, in the book of Genesis, in several parts of the Bible, was established by God. This is Jacob, with the emblem of Ephraim, which is the eagle, established as a safe haven for the people of God from all over the world to come here to learn about Christianity. But the abominations that have been done in this nation has violated every order of God. And when abomination is done against God, he make inquisition for blood. When I say he make inquisition for blood, God has established several irrevocable laws in the spiritual realm. Those irrevocable laws in the spiritual realm, God is not going to change because you are a Christian. There are several penalties that have to be paid when you commit sin, even if you know God or you don't know God. There are several responsibilities that we have as believers in God in Christ Jesus. The believer in Christ Jesus have a big responsibility in this nation. But we have been conditioned that God is going to come down and do everything for us. Oh, yes. The Lord is going to do it. He's going to come down. He's going to do this. Don't just sit tight. All you got to do is believe. But I tell you, obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience is better than sacrifice. As we started today, every Christian believer has a commission in this end time generation. And the commission is listed also in several parts of the Old and New Testament. I'm going to read one. Matthew chapter 10. Verse 7, and as you go preach, saying, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, and raise the dead. Cast out devils, freely, ye have received, freely give. Freely you have received and freely give. So we have a commission. And God has empowered us in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 12. The Holy Spirit gave of Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, you can read that God has given us 9 spiritual gifts. You see, God made provision when he, before he sent us out, he made provisions. And those provisions that God gave us as children of God is for us to utilize us. He gave us talents and he gave us the Holy Spirit gifts. The talents that God has given you, where you can work with your hands, you can make flowers, take decorations, you can earn a living, you can sew, you can braid, you can do hair, you can be a mechanic. He gives us talents. But the Holy Spirit gift is the spiritual gift of God. And we are listed as following. Verse 4, now there are diversities of gifts of the same Spirit. And there are different administrations of the same Lord. And there are diversities of operation, but it's the same God which worketh all in all. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit with all. That's why the word of God said the prophet is worthy of his ire. A prophet is worthy of whatever offering it is given to, whatever salary, a part of the tithe, whatever the board, the prophet is worthy of his hire. For to one is given the spirit of wisdom, that's one. Another the spirit of knowledge, that is same spirit. Another the spirit of faith. The same, so another the gift of healing. And by the same Spirit, to another, the working of miracles, to another, prophecy, to another, the discerning of spirit, and to another, diversities of kinds of tongues, and to other, the interpretation. But all these working as one and self-same Spirit, divided to every man severally, as he will. For as the body is one, and as many members, and all members, that one body being many, are one body also is Christ. Amen? And we have 9 spiritual gifts. You see, God will send us out to do his work. The spiritual gift, the anointing of God, is not for us to keep. One word can save a dying soul. You can give, you, if you have the gift of faith, you can encourage your co-worker, your neighbor. You can give a word of life. Life. You can bring life to the situation. You have the power on your tongue to bring life or death to your circumstance, to whatever you're going through. And let it today have the gift of faith. Whatever, bring a word to a brother, to a sister, in whatever situation they feel, in whatever, and destroy the negativity, and destroy the power of darkness, and depression, and evil thoughts, wicked imagination, because the demons, the fallen angels, do minister to people. And those fallen angels, and the spirits of the devil, Satan, minister to a lot of those people. I will tell them, hit this one, curse, lie. That's all the enemy, his spirit, his evil spirit, his familiar spirit will minister to them. That's why today we living in a state of abomination. Abomination is everywhere. Abomination in the home, in the marriage. Abomination in the businesses. Abomination in the workplace. Abomination in the church. Abomination in the political system. We live in under the curse of abomination because we have decided to receive abomination. When you receive abomination, you become conformed to the world. You become desensitized from spiritual things of God. The spiritual things of God start looking like foolishness to you. The people of God start looking, you start looking at them like your enemy. You become conformed to the standard of the world. You go in agreement and you say, oh, this is my movie, my favorite show, this is my movie star. It is abomination. And when you agree with abomination, whether it's religious abomination, you agree with certain beliefs, you agree with the world people. Some people will say a little marijuana is good for you. Abomination. Then the pattern and the standard of living in a nation that's supposed to be the leading Christian nation that God has ordained, the superpower of the superpower, has become a den of demons and devils. So is the school. So is the church. So is the home. So is this the devil just take reign over everything. The Senate, the Congress, just take reign. Abomination in the nation. So we live in a state of abomination where people will look at evildoers and the workers of iniquity and say they're giving godly counsel. They will get up on TV and say, Naomi and Ruth had a romantic affair, abomination. They will say Jonathan and David had a sexual relationship, abomination. They will say perversion is good. God loves the sinner, but hate the thing, abomination. So we find abomination everywhere. The word of God said in the book of Romans, hallelujah. In the book of Romans, chapter 12, 2. Be not conformed to this world. It says, and be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. Not my will, God, but your will. You may not take, but it's not good for you. You may like this show, but it's not good. Because as you watch these shows, there are some spirits, some satanic and familiar spirits in these movies and this show that will jump into your body and take over. Spirit transfer just by laying your hands on someone. If you let a person who is filled of abomination lay their hands on your children, and later on you see, like, you don't know if that pastor was right or what he was, the children start acting crazy. You see your life change for worse and not for better. Because you allow certain things to enter into your eyes. Because your eyes is the mirror of your soul. So when your eyes start looking and watching abomination, you turn on the TV and you see the fornicators in the soap operas and movies, they start kissing. Then they take off their clothes. And they show the back of their butt naked. They call it soft porno. Abomination. So today we're going to learn about abomination. And how God feels about abomination. And the consequence of abomination. And there are several types of abomination that's being committed right now. Unknowingly. Many today do not understand that abomination has been committed. abomination because of the practice of idolatry. And we find that idolatry is one of the biggest abominations, and God hates idolatry. The children of Israel, after they left Egypt, they decided to commit an abomination before the Lord. They committed abomination, and when Moses saw them, he got angry. He was upset. Moses was lost. And we read from Exodus 32:8. We're going to start here. And God says, "They have turned aside quickly out of the way which I commanded them. They have made them a molten calf and have worshipped it and have sacrificed their unto and say, these be thy God, O Israel, which has brought thee up out of the land of Egypt." After God delivered the children of Israel out of Egypt, 400 years of slavery, part of the Red Sea, that's what they did, an abomination. Exodus 32:25. And when Moses saw that the people were naked, for how Aaron had made them naked unto their shame among their enemies. 31. And Moses returned unto the Lord and said, "Oh, these people have sinned a great sin, and have made them gods of gold." Because it was Aaron who melted the gold with the children and built a golden calf. They built a golden calf, and that golden calf is still being worshipped today, right here in America. It is the bull and the bull horn. They worship the golden calf. Even in New York City, they crushed the golden calf and said, "Give us money." So they're worshiping the golden calf here. They have made molten image. They have committed sacrilege. They have committed abomination. They have worshipped other gods. The witches, the warlocks, the wizards, the voodoo priests, the santeria, the false prophets and the teachers, the false bishops. They have used spells, curses, incantations, charms, enchantments, magic, bewitchment, sorcery, potions, jinx, wami, Acapulcos, without coming to God first, studying the word of God, bowing down and being obedient, but they have chosen to do evil, and they have chosen iniquity over the righteousness and the word of God in this nation. Therefore, the Lord says in Exodus 32:35, "And the Lord plagued the people because they made the calf which Aaron made, because they worshipped the calf, because they committed orgies and abomination, because they rejected what God did for them, that God has brought them a mighty, mighty long way. And instead of following the God of their forefather, they have decided to follow the God of the land where they at. They have decided to pick up on all the idol worship of the children of Egypt and follow in the path of evil." And we pray for this nation on a daily basis. And the Lord said in Exodus 23:24, "Thou shall not bow down to their gods, nor serve them, nor do after their works, but thou shalt utterly overthrow them, and quite break down their images. You shall not have no God before God." And he says, in Malachi 3:18, then shall he return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serve God and between him that serve him not. And that's Malachi 3:18. You see, God has his standard and his rule. He is a jealous God. As God said, there is a consequence. There are some penalties that we are going through in this nation because we have committed abomination. He said, how shall I curse whom God has not cursed? How shall I defy whom the Lord has not defied? But the Lord has established in his word, in the book of Exodus 28, I will curse thee if you disobey, and I will bless thee if you obey me. So you have cursing and blessing. Which have you chosen? Have you chosen to be cursed, or have you chosen to be blessed? Some of us who have chosen to be blessed, we are blessed eternally, because we will be in the kingdom of the Lord. Some of those who have chosen to be cursed, they are cursed to abomination, and there will be with the abomination in the eternal lake of fire. And the Lord says in Numbers 23:19, God is not a man that he should lie, neither the son of man that he should repent. Had he said it and he shall not do it? For had he spoken it, and he shall not make it good? Also, in the book of Hosea, chapter 4, 6, my people are destroyed for lack of knowledge, because thou hast rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that there shall be no priest to me, seeing that thou hast forgotten the law of thy God. I will also forget thy children. And God has done this because we have chosen to practice abomination in our lives. We have chosen to follow the way of evil. We have chosen to worship and to do abomination in this nation. The sin of abomination is tied to the sin of idol worship. And in the book of Galatians chapter 5:20, it says, for idolatry, hallelujah, for idolatry is witchcraft, hatred, strife, jealousy, selfishness, division, and heresies. We see that because of the sin of abomination, because they have committed idolatry in the nation, because of idol worship, because of the sin of idolatry, in the book of Mark chapter 13 verse 14, and we will move there quickly. Thank you, Lord. But when you shall see the abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet, standing where it ought not, let him that readeth understand it, and let them that be in Judea flee to the mountain. And this abomination that is in the book of Daniel chapter 11. That abomination of desolation. The desolation is an abomination, and the geographical location is right here in Jerusalem. In Daniel chapter 12, Daniel expects to us and explain and break it down about the desolation and the abomination that we are going through right now, even in this nation. Daniel chapter 12:11. And from, he says, and from the time that the daily sacrifice shall be taken away, and the abomination that maketh desolate set up, there shall be 1,290 days. So we see that even the abomination of this time is going to be set up in this time period between the 21st through next Wednesday, which is today is the 22nd, through next Wednesday. We're going to see that there's an abomination by an abominator at the end time. And that desolator is Satan, the old dragon. But the abomination is the act. It's the act of disobedience, the act of idolatry, the act of perversion. It is the act of the image of the beast. It is a covenant with the Antichrist, that satanic covenant that is going to be done in Israel between now and Wednesday. It is the abomination that the prophet Daniel is speaking of in the Word of God. Because of the abomination that we have practiced in this nation, because of the many abominations the people suffer today. The people are suffer because they have brought the abomination and the penalties of the abominations on top of their head. We have sexual promiscuity. We have the criminal justice system. We have abominations in the criminal justice system. We got wicked judges and lawyers. We have that are pledged in a criminal justice system to destroy the laws of the land, to dupe the population. We have wicked and evil district attorneys that will conjure up and make false witness and change the law. The law in the courthouse is called the law of president. When a judge rules in this nation and override the laws of the land without the voting of the people, without the free will of the people, without taking vote and asking the people if they will want this law or not, but the law is imposed, the law is signed into executive laws that override the will of the people, is an abomination. So we see the abomination, and we must understand that the penalties of these abominations, God is going to serve us a penalty. We will be paid accordingly to the abomination of the law and the abomination of the land. The abomination that is in the land is going to carry out certain consequences in families and individual lives. But also when the abomination is committed by the individual will pay for the consequence of their abomination. It's called retribution. And that retribution that is given to the individual also will pass on to their family members. In the home, when abomination is committed in the home, and you teach your children abomination, the consequence for that abomination is passed over to your children because of the circumstance and the condition that they were brought up in. So they produce murderers, child molesters in the home because there's abomination in the home. So there's abomination in the community, and that the abomination keeps spreading. There's abomination in the school system, because they're taking out prayers out of the school system, so abomination reigns. And that abomination, you can see it in the school system. They sell drugs in the school system. They molest each other in the school system. They molest each other on the bus. They have sex in the school system. The teachers are having sex with their students. They took an oath to serve and protect the child. An oath to teach an educator as a legal order. But they are chosen to have sex with the students. Principals, raping and molesting. So we see abomination in the schools, abomination everywhere we go. So the land is full of abomination. Therefore, the land is up underneath a curse. We're living up underneath a curse in the nation. And the Christian community has abomination happening in the church. The abomination in the church, where you have the perversion taught in the church. You have perverted men and women who are having sex in the church with their own children. You have perverted evil pastors and preachers who are having sex with women in the church, infected them with HIV. You have perverted preachers who are having sex with young boys and girls. So everywhere we go is abomination in the country. But they are not teaching you contrary how to pray against the abomination, how to live righteously in God's eyes as a Christian. So we have many Christians today practicing abomination. The abomination of the desolation. And the things that are supposed to come upon this nation. Because they have refused to humble themselves unto the Lord and pray. Because they have rejected the prophets who are holy prophets of God. Because they have mocked God and served the beast. They have mocked God and served the beast system. Because they have signed their name in blood. You have abomination in your TV shows. Your TV shows are teaching you abomination. But not only to you, but to your children. You are teaching your sons and your daughters at an early age. 9 years old, 8 years old. To practice perversion. Little girls dressing up like boys. Effeminate boys. At an early age. And parents agree with that. There's abomination in the home. They don't know God. They don't worship God. They don't know Jesus. This generation is a generation of vipers. The generation of vipers that will murder their own parents and kill their parents with their friends. And we live in an era of abomination where we see female prophets and preachers openly saying that they practice the perversion lifestyle. Where we see their preaching with their tits out according to the book of Isaiah 32, 9 through 12. They're preaching naked. They have not covered themselves in holiness. They are not sanctified. They're practicing abomination. Abomination is everywhere. But I will expose the reason why of these abominations so we can see for ourselves that we live in an error. We are living in a time where they call good evil. They're calling the true word of God evil. They're calling evil men and women good. But the Lord God shall deliver you from your abomination. The Lord God will deliver you because The truth will set you free. Sexual abomination. We talk about the spiritual abomination already, which tied into witchcraft, idolatry. We're going to think a little bit about the condition that we hear. It is an abomination of drug addiction and alcohol abuse. The abomination that they commit when they defile their bodies by making concoctions, marijuana, crack cocaine, all types of bath salts, mixing cough syrup with soda, doing all kind of satanic alchemies, potions to get high, is an abomination. All type of drugs that they use, recreational drugs, is abomination. Alcohol abuse is abomination. That's why we have drug driving. Abomination is a young man overdosed on bath salts, and he committed cannibalism. He became a zombie and attacked a man on the street and ate his flesh publicly. Abomination. We find the abomination is continuing growing rapidly in our society. We have abomination of lust and seduction, and when the man and the woman of God are rejected to teach the truth, they will not teach the truth, and they will not speak up against the abomination that is being performed and is in our nation. We have abomination in God's eyes in marriages. Many people marry for different reasons. Love, seduction, married for a green card, married because a man has money, sexual attraction, abomination. Ungodly marriages, satanic covenant, satanic and Luciferian covenant. That's what we call blood witches, where they're married just to produce children for the satanic kingdom. They come together, they get married to join the powers of darkness and to produce children according. That's what we call blood witches. So many born under a satanic covenant, which is an abomination. The abomination in prostitution and pimping. And we read, and the daughter of any priest, if she profane herself by playing the harlot, she profane her father. She shall be burnt with fire, and this is Leviticus 21:9. That's in those days. That's what God tells with abomination. Another abomination. We find in the church there's so much strange fire. And we read, and Nadab and Abihu, the sons of Aaron, took either of them his censer and put fire therein and put incense therein, and offered up a strange fire before the Lord, which he commanded them not. And there went out a fire from God the Lord and devoured them. And they died before the Lord. And that's Leviticus 10:1-2. Because it was an abomination to do these things in the temple. Another abomination that is practiced in the church. Thou shalt not uncover the nakedness of a woman and her daughter. Neither shalt thou take her son's daughter or her daughter's daughter to uncover her nakedness. For they are her near kinswoman, and it is wickedness. Leviticus 18:17. It is an abomination. We find abomination everywhere. We find it in prostitution and pimping, child porn, stripping in this country. And they say it's a law of liberty. But it's an abomination that has been committed in the land. And since the abomination has been committed in the land is polluted. The land is being put to shame. And we read, for the lips of a strange woman drop as honeycomb, and her mouth is smoother than oil, for her head is bitter as wormwood, sharp as a two-edged sword, her feet go down to death, her sex like take all on hell. That's prostitution. Proverbs 5, verse 3 through 5. Proverbs 5, 22-23 reads, his own iniquities shall take the wicked himself, for he shall be holden with the cause of his sins. He shall die without instruction, and in the greatness of his folly, he shall go astray. Proverbs 5, 22-23. This is an abomination for the pimp and for the prostitute. So we have pimping going on in this nation because it says the laws of liberty. Prostitution is against the law. Stripping is okay. But prostitution, it is abomination. So the laws of God have been violated in our community. We have stores that provide sex toys. We have drug dealers. We have all these abominations from in the home to the school to the church to the criminal justice system abomination. And we read, another person, a wicked man, walketh with a forward mouth. He or she winketh his eyes. He speaketh with his feet and teacheth with his fingers. Forwardness is in his heart. He devised mischief continually. He thought this way. And that's Proverbs chapter 6, verse 14. And we find that there are many politicians that fall into this bracket. People that you vote for and put them over your school board. People that you vote for in your state Congress and your state Senate. And they are libertarians, they are communists, they are confederates, they are Luciferians. And you voted for them because you did not know or you knew. Therefore, the land is polluted with abomination. From the bottom to the top is abomination. There's abomination everywhere. And it brings poverty. It brings plague. It brings war. It brings discord. It brings more crime. What there's abomination. The abomination in the land. And no one speaketh. I am the voice in the wilderness. I am Pastor Betak. I'm the voice in the wilderness that cried out against these things. All the sins of Egypt, all the penalties, all the plagues of Egypt shall fall upon this nation. If children of God don't start praying, if we don't start praying and fasting, the plagues are coming. The plagues are coming because of the abomination that's being done in the nation. The plagues. The plagues are coming. The plague, the poverty. And God has said in his word in the book of Leviticus 21:14, neither shall he go out of the sanctuary, nor profane the sanctuary of his God, for the crown of the anointed and oil of God, of his God, is upon him. I am the Lord. That's what we should do. You shall fear the Lord, live in the Lord, believe in the Lord, because you are anointed. You are a Christian. Christian means Christos in Greek. It means anointed one. But the abomination of this end time is truly. Because we have these things in the church. We have a lot of sexual promiscuity, adultery. We have businesses, some businesses and multi-level marketing is just as bad as gambling. And we read from the book of Hosea, it says, for their mother has played the harlot, and she has conceived them and have done shamefully. For she said, I will go after my lovers that gave me bread, that give me my bread and my water, my wool, my flax, and my oil, and my drink. Hosea chapter 2:5. This is the condition that we're living in. Prostitution in the home. Harlotry in the church. Abomination. Because the abomination is so rampant. The plagues of Egypt shall fall upon this nation. We must pray as Christians and cry out. There should be a wailing in the churches. There should be a wailing and a praying and fasting of Christians in this nation. Crying out to God for our, we have committed abomination in the land. We have polluted the nation with our sins and our abomination. The word of God says, let not thine heart decline to our ways. Go not astray in our paths. For she or he has cast down many wounded. Yeah, many strong men have been slain by her. Her house is the way of hell, going down to the chambers of death. Proverbs 7. Verse 26 and 27. And this is the abomination of the harlot. But in this great end time, we find that there will be more spiritual abomination done. That abomination that is done, you will see the abomination. You will see the abomination who is the Antichrist. The Antichrist is an abomination. It is abomination to pretend that you're holy when you are a child of the devil. To pretend that you are Christian and claim that you are Christian, a child of God, but then you're naked and you do satanic videos, satanic oaths, and satanic rituals. It's an abomination for a man and a woman of God to stand up in sheep clothing while they are wolves. It's an abomination for a man or woman of God to be a Freemason or an Eastern Star and still be a pastor. Those things cannot be. Those things should not be. Let us turn to Matthew the 24th chapter, verse 15. Matthew 24, quickly. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We are living in the time of abomination. We are living in the state of abomination. And God is warning us. When ye therefore shall see the abomination of desolation, spoken by the prophet Daniel in the holy place, whosoever readeth, let him understand, or let him understand. The Antichrist is the ultimate abomination. Because the Antichrist is Satan himself, pretending that he is Jesus, your Lord and Savior. How are you going to be able to recognize it? God has given you his timeline. God has given you the marking for you to recognize the abomination. That abominator is Satan. The image of the beast is in the world already. The image of the beast has been worshipped and believe in the spirit of the, they believe in the spirit of the Antichrist from the ages. But when he is manifest, will you as a Christian be able to recognize the abomination, which is the false Christ, the false Jesus, the false Savior, the false Messiah, who is the Antichrist? The word Antichrist means false and fake Savior. You must be able to recognize the abomination that makes desolate the people of God. Because when that abomination appears, he's going to come in peacefully. He's going to look blonde here with a part in the middle, the beard, the little goatee, the blue penetrating eyes, dressed up in fine linen on a white horse with a crown on his face. I am Jesus. I'm your Savior. Come to rapture you away. So you see, the abomination is the rapture doctrine. That mark of the beast that they are going to receive is coming straight from the abominator. It's the abomination is going to appear. The abomination is going to claim like he is the Messiah. He is the Savior of the world. But guess what? He's an abomination. Every abominator. Every form of former sexual bondage. This is the system and the doctrines of the devil. The doctrine of the devil is seduction and lust. The lust of the flesh, the pride of life. He beguiled Eve and he will beguile you. He will beguile Christians in this end time. It says here in Ezekiel 16, verse 17, God has also taken the fear jewels of my gold and of my silver which I have given thee, and made for thyself of limits of men, and did commit whoredom with them, but also committed fornication with the Egyptian and thy neighbors, great afflict, and thus increase thy whoredom, and provoke me to anger. And that's Ezekiel 16, 26. You see, the profane, the abominator, is tied up in the lifestyle that she said is free will. All of that sexual promiscuity, the nakedness, the seductiveness, the lust of the flesh, the wanton to be grandiose, to have power, to be an idol, to be worshipped, to have, to look down on others with holy eyes, the pride of life. It is the abomination of the desolator. To uncover their father's nakedness and sleep with our father's wife is an abomination. And that's the book of Leviticus chapter 20, verse 11. The nakedness of thy father's wife, thou shalt not uncover, it is thy father's nakedness. Leviticus 18, verse 8. And if a man shall take his sister, his father's daughter, his mother's daughter, and see her nakedness, she is his nakedness, it is wicked. It is a wicked thing, and they shall be cut off in the sight of their people. He had uncovered his sister's nakedness, and it's a serious iniquity. Leviticus 20:17. It is an abomination. The nakedness of thy son's daughter, or thy daughter's daughter, and the nakedness thou shalt not uncover in their own nakedness. Leviticus 18:10 is an abomination. The sexual immoralities of the land, the criminology and the criminal mind, the criminal and the perversion of criminal, home invasion, drug dealing, gang banging, whatever you call it, stealing, raping, kidnapping, all the crimes that being committed in the land is an abomination unto the Lord. So therefore, if it doesn't hit home, they don't care. They don't care. And they don't protest against these wicked lawmakers, these evil lobbyists. The lobbyists lobby for the wicked evil laws to be in place. The lobbyists lobby for wicked laws to be instituted in your city, in your community. The evil satanic legs of Satan, those wicked men and women, they walk around and they buy them, oh, who can get a gift? They sold you off. The Senate, your congressmen, the people, they throw you off into the beast system, for abomination is done in the community. And the laws of the land have been destroyed because we would not hearken and humble ourselves and pray against abomination in the land. Therefore, there's a penalty. There's a penalty that God has written from irrevocable laws in the land. When disaster comes, those things mainly man-made. When the evil and the wedge of protection that God has surrounded us in our home, God have a wedge of protection around the cities and certain areas, and those wedge of protection, those are spiritual boundaries of no trespass zones to Satan. When they are broken, it's because Christians will not pray. When those spiritual boundaries are being destroyed, and you see all the desolation and the abomination enter into the school and slaughter children, it's because Christians don't pray. Because Christians have become conformed to the standard of living in the nation. They have become carelessly. They are carelessly in their own church. They receive satanic teachings every Sunday. Sunday, every Wednesday. The church is a meeting ground for demons, and it's become a devil that demons and harlotry. The church has become an abomination in this nation with false prophets, false teachers. You've got spiritual leaders that say they are gay and lesbian. You've got all this in the church. Not in the church. People out there, but not in the church. So it's become an abomination. It's become an abomination in the community, and the land and the church is cursed. Because they have forgotten the laws of God, and they have found themselves conformed to the standard of man, which is abomination. The whole land is polluted because of abomination. Abomination in the home. Abomination in porno movies, in soft porn, in your show, abomination, sexual promiscuity. They go, they on the TV show, they're stealing, they're shooting, they're killing, they're teaching your children to rob, they're teaching your children to curse in the cartoons. The cartoons, all they do is make these little things just fight. Abomination. Christians are receiving abomination on a daily basis. Even in the food that they eat, abomination. They're putting baby fetuses in the soft drink and the food. They're crossbreeding it now with all kind of animals, with sweet and pineapple, with the genes of a pig. You know, abomination. We have received abomination. We eat abomination. The Christian ministers, they don't care. They preach to them with their titties out. Abomination. They said the pastor, he at least he's a man of God. I don't care, he didn't do it. Okay, abomination. But we have desanctified. We have separated ourselves from God and the laws of God. We are desanctified. We have separated ourselves from God. So therefore, there's consequence, because the word of God said, the day you sin, you shall surely die. The wages of sin is death. Separation from God, spiritually. Some of y'all are the walking living dead. You can be breathing, but you're spiritually dead. You can be walking, but you're dead spiritually. Dead bones walking around. Because abomination. Because when we go to church and we don't hear truth, we agree with the abomination in the pulpit. It's just simple. Abomination. We say it's okay. At least I got something out of it. But in the book of Leviticus chapter 18, you shall also read, and thou shalt not approach unto a woman to uncover her nakedness, as long as she put upon her uncleanness, having sex with a woman, for a woman having sex with a man on her period, on her monthly cycle, is an abomination. So you see, this is abomination. And if a man shall lie with a woman having a sickness, and shall uncover her nakedness, he has discovered a fountain, and she has uncovered the fountain of her blood, and both of them shall be cut off. Abomination. Leviticus chapter 20. So we find all type of abomination. Satanic abomination, we have Molech worshipping in a big, tall, 30 feet Molech image. We got the people have candles in the home. So you got abomination from the house. In the heart, there's abomination. And the ultimate abomination is the Antichrist. That is the ultimate abomination. It's to worship the image. It's to worship the image of the Antichrist. And those who worship the image of the Antichrist shall be burnt up. They're going to burn. Because Christians don't know the difference between the false and the true. They have not studied the word of God. They have not seen God for themselves. In the book of Revelation, in the book of Revelation, chapter 13, 16. The book of Revelation, chapter 13, 16, read as follows. Hallelujah. We have to pray for our nation. And he hath power to give life unto the image of the beast. The image of the beast shall both speak I call that as many as will not worship the image of the beast to be killed. So you have a choice. Your choice is to choose between eternal life or death. The word of God says you try to save your life, you shall lose eternally. You will lose your life. So these things are not being taught in church. So I'm the voice that is crying out in the wilderness. I say it's an abomination. That abomination is going to present himself to the people. The spirit of the abomination is right here. And this is how you're going to deceive them. It says here in verse 14 of the same Revelation 13, and deceive them that dwell on the earth by the means of those miracles which he has power to do in the sight of the beast, saying to them that dwell on the earth that they shall make an image of the beast which had and wound by a sword and live. And we studied about that deadly wound yesterday. We studied about the system that's going to be wounded. And the system has been wounded in four dynasties. The education next year, they're going to shut down so many schools. The healthcare is already failing. So you have education and healthcare failing. We have economy. Every month in the county where I live, 2,000, 3,000 people lose their home. If the economy has been healed or healing, that deadly wound is still here. And we look like the laws are still changing because the evil lobbyists, the legs of Satan, the legs of abomination, the abominable laws that they're placing in place because the lobbyists will write up these laws. And these laws come from the Luciferians. These Luciferian laws and the curses are in place. Adultery is an abomination. The Bible says in Leviticus 18:20, moreover, thou shalt not lie carnally with thy neighbor's wife or husband, and defile thyself with her or with him. Leviticus 18:20, and there's consequence for adultery, even sickness and disease. And the man that committed adultery or the woman with another man, wife or husband, even that committed adultery with his neighbor's wife, the adulterer and the adulteress shall be surely put to death. But Jesus is a merciful God. Because when he caught the woman in the act, the only one is to stone the woman. And he bent down and he said, start writing on the sand. Where are the accusers? When you ask for forgiveness, God forgives you. Through the blood of Jesus is the only way of forgiveness. Those who know him or get to know him ask for forgiveness. Sometimes there are several penalties that we have to pay, but God is merciful. I say he loves us, he loves you, he is merciful. And it says now, if a man lying with his lie with mankind, with his own kind, and he lied with a woman, both of them have committed abomination, and they shall be surely put to death, for their blood shall be upon them. If a man or a woman lie with their own kind, and natural affection, the word of God says Leviticus 20:13 is an abomination in God's eyes. And if a man lies with a beast, with an animal, he shall be put to death as abomination. Leviticus 20, verses 15 and 16. So we're living in a time of abomination. We're living in an end time of abomination. We have the false prophet who is going to come out and be the one that paves the way for the Antichrist. He speaketh lies. He does miracles. He evangelizes in the whole world for Jesus. But it's not for Jesus. It's for the false Jesus. How many Christians know the truth? How many Christians going to be destroyed, oh Lord? Many Christians shall be destroyed. All else will be destroyed, oh Lord. Because that leads to their own understanding. Because they have decided to listen to a wicked man and a wicked pastor and a wicked teacher. Because they were not hearken themselves. I am the voice that cried in the wilderness in this end time. I'm one of the voices that speak it. I've been ordained from the foundation of the earth to speak truth, to bring a word of truth, to bring a word of knowledge, to bring a word of life. And I'm crying out against the abomination. Father God, I thank you. because of the plagues, because of the plagues and the carnage that the enemy wants to do in this country against the Christians. Right now in Africa, the Boko Haram is killing Christians on a daily basis. In Sudan and East Africa, they're killing them. The tribulation is now. They're telling them, you going to bow to this religion or you going to be a Christian or what? And they say, I'd rather be a Christian and die. People are dying and saying they're not going back to that abomination. They are killing them. They sent me a picture with a pregnant woman where they cut off her limbs and she was dead. But they said the baby that was trying to get the baby out because they said she was 8 months pregnant. They said the baby may be still alive. So they found her and brought her half dead to the clinic. You see, this is a price that Christians paying right now in Africa. And standing up and saying, I am a Christian and I'd rather die. I'd rather the Boko Haram chop me up, but I'm not going to bow down to the abomination. What is going to happen here in America? And the wicked pastors and the wicked teachers will not warn the people of God. Therefore, plagues, carnage, poverty, joblessness, homelessness, all these things are taking place here because the Christians will not pray. They will not humble themselves unto God. They have received abomination on the TV, in their souls, and they talk of abomination, rituals. They have joined the abomination. They also are ritualist pastors that are Freemasons of China. They have received abomination. They have received the rapture doctrine with an abomination because the rapture doctrine, who don't who believe it, cannot have the seal of God. They do not have the Holy Spirit. Because the Holy Spirit will bring you into all truth. So therefore, if they have the Holy Spirit, they will know that the first one that is coming is six come before seven. When you count six before seven. And it says he comes at the sixth trumpet. And then for the true Jesus comes at the seventh trumpet. Do they know how to count? It's elemental. The sixth file coming before the seventh file. The sixth seal comes before the seventh seal. And we go straight into the millennium. 1,000 years of teaching. Where Satan and his fallen angels going to be bound up. And Jesus will rule with the rod of iron. Read Revelation 19 and 20 for yourself. Where is the rapture? Where all the nations will be here. And he shall rule them for 1,000 years. Where is your rapture doctrine, false prophet? They are harvesting the souls for the devil. They are harvesting the souls for Satan. They are ushering with satanic covering, satanic prophecy, so you can receive the mark of the beast. The mark of the beast is the rapture. You be sealed with a false prophecy into worshiping the Antichrist. Thank you, Father, for this word. Thank you, Father God, and hold back the plagues of Egypt that you have prepared for this nation. Father God, have mercy upon your children right now. You say in the book of Genesis, when Abraham asked it, there'll be 50 good ones, 50 good people in Sodom and Gomorrah, and will save it. We pray for those who know you, and I pray for those who don't know you. Father God, have mercy upon us. Bless your word right now in Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Be blessed, be encouraged, and have a wonderful and blessed weekend. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord encourage you. You and your family be blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Remember Luke chapter 10, 18 and 19. Behold, I give you power. Defeat Satan in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. I defeat you, Satan, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Be blessed and be encouraged. Amen.